Here's me testing my multiplayer game on two different laptops on two different connections. As a one-man company, I like building multiplayer games because I think it's easier to focus on the gameplay rather than storytelling or AI. The entire goal of this project is to set up one core game mechanic, which is a character controller, and then have the players fight each other to the end. I don't have the resources to create complex level designs, NPCs, items, or open world that are popular in today's AAA games. Personally, I've always felt like games are more addictive when the focus is on humans playing with or against other human players. If you're playing this game with a friend, you can set up a server and allow your friend, as client, to make a TCP connection. Client will constantly send over input data. You, as a server, will process that information, as in take care of physics as well as all the game mechanics, and send player data like positions in different states to the client. All client has to do is receive the info and render it on the screen. This is primitive compared to an elaborate scheme that you can see in some of today's multiplayer games, but it gets the job done. The ultimate question is, where do you settle between 100% input responsiveness versus 100% accurate representation of data that's on the server, which is always lagging behind by the time you're receiving it and making decisions based on it? Simply put, you can't have your cake and eat it too. So on every frame, I'm making a prediction on where the player should be if you didn't have to sync with the server. This is done until you receive actual player position from the server. The rest is interpolating from current position to a midpoint. Yellow represents the prediction, blue represents character model position, and red represents data received from the server. As gamers, we know that at a certain point, too much ping is going to make any game unplayable, meaning no netcode can compensate for something like 200 ping. So from here, all I can do is hope that the internet is fast enough and you're not trying to play with someone that's on the other side of the world. This project is available in my public repository, so you can check it out. All the links are in the description. One thing that's not in the repository is the pixel art, which I don't own. I bought them from itch.io. They've been replaced by basic shapes and colors. I've taken existing code from a C# networking tutorial by Tom Weiland, and I've modified it to fit my project. Most popular languages, including C#, already have APIs where you set up a TCP connection, and how you use that to create your game is up to you. As for my game, all I'm doing is having two or more instances of the character controller and allowing data from the client to affect one of those instances. I know this isn't some advanced rollbacks or prediction-based networking, maybe I'll try to implement those later on, but for now, I'm happy enough with the results. I've been extremely busy with personal stuff lately, so development was halted for almost 2 months. But perhaps next is completing the fight stage, as well as having more UI to show you what's going on, allow you to navigate through different menus, or maybe put in more attack moves and combos. I'll make the decisions as I go. Hopefully soon enough I'll be able to invite some of my friends to come over and play this game. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. Until next time.